Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the mystery of the Holy Trinity is the greatest and most ancient of Christian faith. This is also the most profound doctrine which, in order for us to accept it, requires of us, believers in Christ, first of all, a good sense of trust in his teaching handed over to the Church. In fact, it was Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, Son of God and God himself, who teaches humanity the truth of God, one and unique in nature, though reveals himself in three divine persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Jesus, during his saving mission on earth, repeatedly tells us that he came into the world not on his own initiative, but according to the holy will of God, his Father. He shows his great and deep delight in fulfilling the Father's decree that the sinful humanity should be freed from the power of death and eternal punishment at all costs, even at the cost of the life of the Son of God. Jesus did complete his Father's salvation plan to the last drop of his blood. That was the reason why God the Father once introduced Jesus to all human beings with affectionate and proud words, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." In his turn, Jesus, before going back to his Father, trustfully and respectfully recommends to us, his followers, the Holy Spirit, who said comes from both Father and Son, and who will help us to live up the good news of Christ to all perfection. In short, as Jesus' disciples, we are so loved by the Holy Trinity that we are proud to be named Christians and also Trinitarians. God the Father created us in his image. God the Son laid down his life on the cross to save us from the forces of evil. God the Holy Spirit makes us worthy children of the triune God. How should we Christians conduct such a life that reflects our dignity as children of the God who is love and who has manifested in all aspects of his divine mercy his faithful dream that we will one day gather as one family in his home to share with him everlasting and ever happy life? Let us listen to Jesus, who tells us how now is the time when God the Father wants us to love him and serve him in the Holy Spirit and truth. Saint Paul also wrote that the Holy Spirit teaches us how to pray by addressing God as Father. Let us not forget that we, through the power of the sacrament of baptism, were born again into the new life of divine adoption in the holy name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Let us make this divine life grow up to the fullness of the life of Christ Jesus, with unity with the Father and the Holy Spirit. Amen.